What is going on, peeps? Welcome to a special edition of Character Wars. This episode is going to feature placement battles that will determine the seedings for the upcoming 32-team tournament that will determine our 2-versus-2 champions here on Character Wars. Well, I'm going to keep the intro short and sweet here, kind of keep all the battles and teams in action a surprise, so let's send it to our first placement battle. And we are underway with our first battle featuring the re-debuting Beavis and Butthead. They'll be squaring off against Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees, who are currently sporting an 0-1 record in 2-versus-2 competitions. Well, Freddy and Jason, they definitely need a victory here today, folks. They don't want to fall to the bottom tier of the 32-team tournament. And to fight one of those super spam teams in round one could be over for him here. Well, Beavis and Butthead debuting here. And early on, well, it looks like kind of keeps filling each other out as Beavis and Butthead seem to have found an opening here. Finally, our serial killers working their way back into this here. Beavis and Butthead kind of cornered now. Metal damage, so it looks like a bunch of counters being issued here by the serial killers. Freddy and Jason have found their rhythm here, folks. Jason going into a killer rage, knocked out of it here, folks. Beavis and Butthead trying to rally here late, take out Jason Voorhees. Freddy knocked up into the fan of death there. And well, he's defending him. Hockaloogie looks like it may have KO'd him. Beavis and Butthead take round one. Wow, that one could have went either way there. The serial killers tried to bounce back. Well, round two starts off with Jason trying to use that killer rage. Doesn't look like he connected there. Well, Beavis getting slashed up pretty bad, and well, Butthead knocked back for his trouble. Freddy and Jason chaining the combos here as finally Beavis able to interrupt. Freddy and Jason defending here, going to work. Beavis nearly KO'd, and Butthead hanging around here as Beavis went for the low headspin. Was able to take out Jason with the Cornholio special. It looks like Butthead trying to, do what he can to take out Jason. Butthead down! And, well, no, he's in it still, folks. I thought he was out. Now he's going to be down as well. Freddy drinks his soul. Beavis left to fit for himself here. A one-versus-one match, and Freddy slashes away to take round two. And he's having a good laugh there. Look at him with that silly fedora hat and crazy Christmas sweater. Our final round underway here with Beavis and Butthead immediately going to work with a big combo here. Beavis powering up, I should say Butthead powering up there. Wasted there as well. Beavis and Butthead knocked back. Looks like Beavis rushing in with the chainsaw. Jason taking some massive damage here. Well, he got a hold of Butthead, slashing into him as well. Beavis goes to work. Freddy goes to work on Beavis, I should say here, folks. Beavis powers up, uses the firecracker special, takes out Jason as, well, looks like Freddy pinned in the corner here. Double team assault from Beavis and Butthead. Freddy doing what he can to fend off our MTV superstars here. And, well, our delinquent youths look like they might have Freddy taken out. Yep, the firecracker special took it. Well, Beavis was on fire there, folks. And I can't believe it, Beavis and Butthead debut with a successful victory as well. We got the parade of fail. Oh, man. Ah! And, well, there it is, folks. Yes, Beavis and Butthead debuting with a successful match there. And don't call me a butt knocker, you son of a bitch, anyhow. Well, Freddy and Jason, what the heck's wrong with them? Folks, they can't buy a victory here. Even after being powered up for their second official battle, there are just no luck. Anyhow, our first, 32-team tournament placement battle has concluded here, folks. And up next, I will have another one ready to go for you. Our next placement battle is underway, featuring the undefeated team, Neo Mega Man. They'll be battling, well, Dante and Richter Belmont, who suffered a tough loss in their initial debut here. So, well, this could be good for Neo Mega Man, or it could be really bad for Dante and Richter Belmont here. Could be looking at one of the lower seeded teams in the tournament. You don't belong in this world. I don't know. Dante and Richter, you'd think they'd be pretty high impact here. And we didn't have to go through one of Mega Man's long intros here this time. How interesting. Well, immediately here, Neo tried to go to work. Dante knocked back as well. Now he is not knocked back. Expanding his offense here. Neo taking the air and Richter chain. Mega Man trying to charge up here as well. It looks like they might have Dante in a kind of team situation. He's knocked back. Neo using those matrix-like abilities here as Mega Man charges up his range. There we go. Dante slashes here as Richter tries to power up here. Looks like Dante will do what he can. Well, Mega Man and synergizing well, it would seem here. But, well, this one pretty much back and forth. The O team really has a clear-cut advantage right now. Looks like Mega Man's trying to spam away on Richter here as Dante and Neo going at it at the top of the cage. Looks like Dante got the best of that exchange. If I say that, Neo takes out the big chopper, takes out Dante, and moves Richter into handicap situation. There's the chopper again, and that minigun takes out Richter Belmont as well. And Neo Mega Man takes round one, in which was definitely highly competitive. Our second round underway here. And Dante going to work immediately on Mega Man here as Neo charges up here. Richter trying to use his ranged offense, twirling that chain whip there. So Neo grabs him, starts punching away here. And we see hints of the Matrix being unleashed here. Neo trying to go against Richter. Get the best of that exchange, it looks like. Richter's stunlocked right now. Dante using his ultimate abilities here, trying to power up to the next level here. However, that big chain gun off that helicopter from Neo. He and Span here. Dante taking that again. And Neo Mega Man looking super impressive here. Hydro Storm unleashed. That might take out Mega Man. I think he's down. It looks like Neo is in a handicap situation here, but, well, I think he's going to take it here, folks. Looks like Richter has hardly any health left here. It's a bona fide one-versus-one match. Richter, ultimate ability here, but Neo's getting through. Richter hanging on with a little bit of health, misses the axe toss, and Neo makes him pay. Consecutive rounds. Team Neo Mega Man staying undefeated. And Dante and Richter, another tough loss. It was consecutive rounds. They put together some nice offense there, folks. Just couldn't find it in them to take a round, though. And, well, they're still 0-2. Tough loss heading into the tournament for them. Like I said, we're still a ways away from the 32-team tournament, so maybe Dante and Richter will have a chance to improve their standings again here. Only time will tell that, folks. And, well, up next, I will have another battle ready to go for you all. Our next placement battle is underway. Team Lobo Underdog, looking to bounce back after their tough initial debut loss, will be facing Captain America and Captain Caveman from the Captain's Club, officially debuting their faction in the 2-versus-2 tournament here, I guess. Here is, well, Captain Falcon apparently sitting at home, letting America and Caveman team up here. Two Derek Rowell creations battling it out here in the cage. We may have to put the cage back together after this one. That would be a man of destruction, folks. Anyhow, Caveman ready to go. His club is powered up, and Lobo and Underdog seem ready to go here, folks. Captain shield spamming here. Lobo missing that gun. Captain America just kind of standing back here. Looks like the shield charge. Lobo knocked back for his trouble. Final Justice connecting. Hypercharge blocked. And well, who took the brunt of that? Underdog trying to power up. And, where'd he go? He comes crashing down. Not Lobo in a bad spot. It's Captain America. I believe he's low-rated here. Lobo Underdog. Lobo takes that big space chopper. I don't know what that connected to. It looks like it might have hit Captain Caveman. Really spamming the big space chopper here. And somehow Lobo Underdog seemed to bounce back here as Captain America hit that charging star. The giant hammer attack was Captain Caveman. Turning his club into the giant mallet. That took out Lobo Underdog left in a handicap situation. Spammy away here. And this should just about do it for Underdog. Yeah, raining down molten lava out of that club. Nowhere for Underdog to hide. And the hits on that combo just rack up. Captain America, Captain Caveman take round one. It looked a little bit closer than I thought it was going to be there. Man, Captain Caveman almost got knocked out. Let's see what happens. Round two underway. Stars and Stripes and Charging Star. Along with the Final Justice going. Lobo knocked back. Looks like he takes the charger, or the space chopper, I should say. That all connected on Captain America. Going Lobo. I should say Underdog and Caveman going at it on the other side of the cage here. Looks like Underdog gets the better of that exchange. Another space motorcycle spam from Lobo. And Lobo and Underdog just spamming their combos endlessly here in round two. Captain America just absolutely locked in place. Underdog tossing away. Don't count out the Captain's Club yet. Here, folks, are trying to find some offense. Oh, I guess you can count them out now as Captain America has been Batman KO'd as well, and man, I'm gonna have a mild heart attack after that battle. Jeez. Underdog. How did Lobo and Underdog take that and force the third round here? Our final round underway here, folks, and well, Captain America knocked back here as Captain Caveman powers up. What's he doing? We won't know. His special was interrupted by the grenade launcher there. Those homing grenades or rockets going to work there. Captain Caveman trying another special. Powers up the Mega Mallet. I don't think he connected as well. Captain America is locked in a chain of punches and kicks there. Spamming his Lobo there, actually carrying his weight there. Captain America showing that he can spam as well. I think he got KO'd though. Looks like no, Captain Caveman got KO'd. The space chopper coming out. And well, I could not follow the action at all in this one. I can just tell you that Lobo Underdog definitely was able to take that one.
No one messes with me. The main man and the main dog get a victory here. Bounce back. Anyhow,
man, action all over the place in that highly competitive three-round showdown. Lobo Underdog, well, they successfully get a victory there. Bounce back after their tough debut loss. Well, the Captain's Club, they gave it what they could, almost took it. Went to a third round there, and well, Captain Caveman and Captain America, I'm sure, definitely are going to look to try to improve their seeding before the tournament begins here, folks. Well, that battle was all over the place, and I apologize if my commentary was less than good in that one here. Anyhow, let's send it to our next battle. And our next placement battle is underway. It features Homer Simpson and Peter Griffin looking to bounce back after their initial debut loss. They'll be battling Team Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, being represented by Leonardo and Michelangelo here. I guess Donnie and Raph kind of taking like Captain Falcon's approach, just sitting back letting the other turtles kind of fight it out here. Retro Homer, man. Well, finally realizes he's not in the 80s anymore, apparently, here. Well, this one is underway and ready to go here, folks. With Leo getting in there, going to work on Homer. Peter counters that, since Leo back. Homer with a donut dog. Peter getting tossed into our camera here. Well, Homer trying to use his ranged offense. Looks like we got Peter taking some steroids here, trying to unleash the asses of fire here. And Leo missed that katana smash here. And Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, well, really letting Homer and Peter kind of just bring the fight to them. Peter getting tossed into our camera again here. Looks like, well, Mikey in big trouble here. Peter getting the best of his exchange here. Homer and Peter kind of fighting out here. Nausea night here for Peter Griffin. That connected hit both of our turtles as Homer goes to work, kicking the crap out of Mikey, leaving Leo to fend up both Peter and Homer here, and that is not going to be good. Peter grabs Homer, or I should say Peter grabs Leo, punches the crap out of him, and Peter gives us the middle finger. Wacky, waveable, inflatable arm tube man here, and Homer doing karate. Peter super happy there. Round two underway, and well, our turtles doing a little better here. Leo getting the katana barrage here. Stun locking Peter here. And Mikey trying to get his combo interrupted here. Homer. Double team assault as Peter gets tossed in the camera for about the 18th time in this battle here. Double team on Mikey there as well. Leo goes to work here. Hits another katana barrage. Peter's been KO'd, and well, Homer going for the death touch, trying to save his team here. Maybe get the consecutive victory. Another death touch. And well, don't count out Homer. He's able to maybe run the gauntlet here. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles breaks his combo here. Tosses Homer into the camera, who comes crashing back. And the sky pile driver from Michelangelo takes him out. Our turtles take round two. And let's see this one coming to the third and final round here. Peter moving ahead here, and one knocked back for a shuffle by Leonardo's big combo. On a barrage is Mikey jumping around here, waiting for Homer and Peter as they come crashing down. Wow, the turtles unleash a 78-hit, 80-hit combo to get things going here. Finally, well, Peter and Homer trying to find some offense here. A little late, maybe. Mikey comboed here. Peter doing what he can to make this interesting here, but it looks like Leo and Mikey may have way too big of a health advantage here. Homer down. And the multiple fireball parts there didn't help Peter. He goes to the top of the cage, tries to do his hand. Maybe spam something on Michelangelo. He comes crashing down, but our turtles were waiting for him. Team Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle, successful debut, cowabunga indeed. Homer and Peter, what is wrong with them? I've seen them run the nearly take out like Goku and Piccolo. I've had some interesting off-camera scenarios with them, and now they can't even get it done against our turtle team here. Well, that one might hurt them more than they know heading into the 32-team tournament here, folks. These placement battles, well, they'll kind of determine seeding, like I say, later on down the line here. Anyhow, I'm going to move on to our final placement battle of this special edition of Character Wars here. And our final placement battle of this Character Wars special edition is underway! Kyo 13 and Ogre looking to stay undefeated. Battle Sumeragi, Kuon, and Lu, who are also looking to stay undefeated in our Super Fan main event here. And these teams are definitely higher tier, as you'll see here, by their spamminess and aggressive AIs. Like, I nerfed attack defense and life appropriately here. Even though these teams might seem super brutal, folks, I'm sure we have some other teams of choice. Apparently, Kuon was not aware that he was going to be in action here, as Kyo 13 and Ogre absolutely just unload on him to get things going. Now Lu, the victim of Ogre's offense here, finally, well, looks like Kuon's back in the fray here, slashes away, as will Kyo 13 unleash that lion. Ogre invincible here, and, well, Kyo 13 and Ogre not even breaking a sweat in round one. Looks like Kuon vows to be back here. That was only a scratch, he's saying. Well, he powers up on the round even quick here. Looks like he's going for a major combo, and he does here. Kyo 13 in huge trouble, being spammed away as Ogre tries to do what he can against Lu here. Kyo spamming his flaming ability here, and is his inner wolf, I guess we can say here. The 999 hit combo nearly finishes off Kuon and Lu, but they are still in it. Maybe down and out now, folks. Yeah, looks like it. And Kuon spamming here is taking out Kyo 13. Ogre trying to go for the consecutive round victories here. Looks like Kuon is in trouble. And as I say that, well, Kuon able to power up one of his ultras, flashing away here. Looks like that one. He's deflecting Ogre's offense pretty well. Sword smash connects. And I think that's going to even it up. Down, and Ogre is out. In round two, Kuon hangs on by a thread to force a third round. And our Super Fan main event is going to come to an end in the first. It's going to take it. Time's going to tell. Looks like Kyo 13 gets the best of Lu. And, well, that play breath connected on Kuon as well here. All over the place, trying to find it here. A massive spike of energy being released from Kuon. Kyo 13 and Ogre locked in place. I think Ogre's down. Ogre's down. Kyo 13 is down. And Kuon and Lu bounce back and take two consecutive rounds to win the battle. Remain undefeated here. And hand Kyo 13 and Ogre their first official loss. Wow, both those teams. I would hate to be any of the teams that don't have. You got to bring your absolute A game against any of these super spammy offenses. And we've yet to see Broly and Ignis Scarlet, the other super spam team, unleashed here, too. When will they debut? Only time will tell, folks, here. We still have several other teams to debut. Like I say, I've probably got, I don't know, maybe. I'll have to check the official number, but I'll estimate maybe like 13 to 15 teams we've seen officially debut that we're going to see in the tournament thus far. Some of these like lesser jobber teams, they aren't going to officially qualify for the tournament. So like I say, as these placement battles sort out more and more, the 32-team tournament, we'll have a clearer picture of who's going to be participating and kind of where everyone's going to be sitting here. But that'll be further on down the line, folks. Along with tomorrow, I should have our regular edition of Character Wars scheduled to upload here. I certainly hope you all enjoyed this special edition of 2 vs 2 placement battles here for our upcoming 32-team tournament, and I hope you will tune in again for more Character Wars powered by MUGEN!